kings, queens, and anybody else that's possibly on the rise in between. My name is Charles Daquan, and I want to welcome everybody back to the season 2 recap, but not other than you would. Now listen, I want to jump right into business because I want y'all to understand how this freshman showcase really was a vibe, and it really showcased how the freshmen on the rise of this season really executed, if you get what I'm saying, right? So starting out with Hemi's performance was give me one word.
Amazing.
That's the word we're gonna go with right here. It was amazing. If you know anything about Hemi's performance, matter of fact, I don't even want to get into it. Go watch. So Hemi, you got yourself a new fan, my guy. I'm sorry to break it to anybody that don't like Hemi, but I'm telling you right now, I'm a fan, right? You got me. I love how you carried it 10 toes down when it came to Teji. Teji, you know you my guy too, but I just don't understand how you might be playing both sides. You got me looking at you sideways. I don't really know what's going on because for one moment, your castmates is feeling like that look right there. They feeling like that. And then, matter of fact, Teji, is Doc your homeboy? Because if Doc is your homeboy, I understand why you're carrying him like that. I just get it. You feel me? I would carry my homeboy like that too. But I would also carry him the same way around my friends. Can somebody call Doc? I want to talk to Doc. I want to know if Doc, if he feel like that his friend choosing sides. Like, now I got to ask Doc. Now, Vigorous's performance wasn't really much to call home to mom about, as the people would say. But I think that the song was amazing. I got to say this. I got to put it on the floor. Ayo is a clown. Ayo is a clown because he literally went to Rara and tried to like stir fry a little bit, tried to be real like crafty with it, but like, come on, Bozo, we seen what you did there. We seen it. I think the biggest thing that got me was when Drell told me that you was background singing for him, and then he gave you all your accolades. I know the boys love you.
They do.
And I know you love
them. Yes.
If you could give me, I'm gonna name all your cast members. I want you to give me a word for each of them. And I don't want you to rush the word.
Okay.
I want you to take your time with the word because I feel like they gonna see it.
Yeah. Heard. Avery.
Heard. I got follow up. Jeff.
Friend.
Follow up with Hemi.
Creative.
J2.
Can I say two words? Can I say two words?
Just cause of J2, yeah, you can say it.
Real
nigga. I'm gonna keep going. I got that.
Skill.
Vigorous.
Passionate.
Okay. Am I missing my ass besides that?
Yes, you didn't say Ayo or Teji.
Oh, we're gonna skip Ayo. Teji.
Determined.
All right, I guess we can go to Ayo. Ayo.
You guess you can go to Ayo. Don't do him like that.
I'm a little confused. From this episode right here, I'm a little confused on what he's trying to do.
Ayo was my first baby. That was my first heart. He will always be my first heart.
You need to put him back in the crib.
That will be my first heart always and forever. So we not gonna do him like that. But,
there's a thought process behind this one.
Because I'm trying to think of one word that I'm trying to say.
Trying to make it sound good.
No. Brandable.
Man, I ain't even mad at that one right there. I ain't even mad at that. That's a good one. Okay. Every day, yeah. I can't take no credit.
Last week, it was a crazy ass episode, but y'all ain't seen nothing yet.
Y'all, when y'all see this, I love y'all so much, but that was funny as hell.
I want y'all to show some motherfucking love for my boy, Vigorous.
Happiness is
I
I just don't, I feel like it's a time and a place for everything.
He recognized and realized that, oh, tonight's crowd is tough.
But this ain't the first time that I've seen him perform and not command that crowd.
Can't kick the shit because it's shit going on.
Talking you're about that nigga man. Being out of here. That's his fault.
Scared. You scared the man. He
and that's
quit.
Fine.
I can give two fucks. Zero fucks given.
Did you win tonight?
I did. It takes you back to those, you know how they say, like, people don't beg and plead no more.
Yes.
They don't sing and rap no more. It takes you back.
You are looking at a legend in the flesh. Fresh about the kitchen to the check. Blew a quarter key on the set. Hold up. Pose.
There was a little back and forth between your brother.
Taji?
Oh, yeah.
You're kind of like a dead man in the front.
So it was like one of those things where I don't want to talk no more.
Thought I wasn't going to find out what was said. Now I know what was said.
Like you're doing the absolute most, so I'm not going to do this with you.
Ain't been in them bills, rummy them cleats while I hit my cha-cha. I'm a yes, you a uh-uh. Big thing and I'm gonna go pop-pop. Tough talk, but they ain't gonna stop. Yeah, while I hit my cha-cha. You a no, I'm a uh-huh. Say hi and I'm a whole aqua. Come to me, casa, break off, pop-pop. Yeah, while I hit my cha-cha. I'm a yes, you a uh-uh. Big thing and I'm gonna go pop-pop. Tough talk, but they ain't gonna stop. Yeah, while I hit my cha-cha. You a no, I'm a uh-huh. Yo, for the group to come out and support, it was all love. I truly, truly appreciate it. Wasn't for sure who all was coming, but those who actually came, you know, I appreciate the support.
Can't stop, won't stop, nigga. Yeah. Can't stop, won't stop, never stop. Can't stop, won't stop, never. Can't stop, won't stop, bad boy. Always upgrading from my last whore. I don't fuck Marisha, Keisha, and Joy. And I ain't tripping if you give me any joy.
The process of filming for The Deception, it was pretty dope. Like, you know, it was my first time really having an actual project. So the way I thought filming was going to go, it wasn't, you know, kind of like jumped around to different scenes and things like that. So it was honestly dope to see everything come together because we did not film it.
Commit the crime and fuck the case. I've been on you for too long. Why you playing with me? Give you the greatest love of all. Houston Whitney. I pull it out the dickies. I leave you sticky. You busting like a piggy. Hit the kitties. I lick on the kitties.
I'm not doing that TikTok shit, man. I rap.
Okay, Nikki. We'll rap harder. Music changes. And if you can't adjust to a new sound, then how much of an artist are you?
My fans love me because of my lyricism. Not a lot of dudes in the game really spitting for real. That's what they love J-Rome for. I'm not doing that Kids Bop Mickey Mouse Club shit y'all want me to do.
As nice as that sounds, J-Rome, your core audience isn't buying records. 14,000 units is what the last project sold. 14! Do you know how much money the label put into that project?
Okay, I get it.
Do you? Do you get it? It took 7 months for your first single off the album to go gold. The double platinum selling J-Rome can't move more than 500,000 units.
What? That's me? Yo, this shit is dope as fuck. Like, especially seeing myself, like, really getting my acting on. Like, hey, I felt proud of myself. Real good.
We put way too much money into you as one of our top billers for you to be out here performing like an indie artist.
Well, the night went amazing. Fans came out to support. Friends and family came out to support. You know, after the premiere, you know, we went up the street and did a little after party. So the night was a good night.
I'm coming. I mean, I'm coming. But, like, I just thought,
Auntie G. You know
what? Auntie G.
Okay, well, here's your first exercise. We're going to rise up off the stage.
Yeah, and we're going to rise up.
We getting there one day at a time. Shit. All right,
rise up.
One day at a time.
We can be going on in this, on in here.
I go. I get to it. I already know that. I want it all back. I want it all back. So I was thinking there we do that part. I want it all back. I want it all back. I want it all back. Okay. So I think what he was saying yesterday in the rehearsal was that. Do all of the, so I want it backs, do it in the mic, but the woos and the A, don't do it directly in the mic. Cause remember we're recording, we're multi-tracking, so we're recording vocals tonight basically. So do your filler stuff, not in the mic, but anything that's directly background. So like the I want it bad, we want that in the track. So put sing that in the mic. So just kind of gauge your, you know, like, hey, you know, your little ghetto stuff. Step back. We want it, but just step back. So now we're heading in the sound check for my concert, The Reclaiming. The Reclaiming is my first anything since I released my last EP in 2019. I have not done anything solo-wise since then. So The Reclaiming is just an opportunity for me to come together with one of my good girlfriends, Jessie Music, and we decided to put this together because as a collaborative effort, because neither one of us have done anything for our solo careers in years. I think her last thing was 2020, mine was 2019. So it was time for us to do something. And the best way to do it is to reclaim a spot that belongs to us.
The show starts.
Comeback concert than to debut the new Team Danae. So this is the singers that I chose from my audition process. This is their very, very first concert with me. And so of course I'm in a panic. This is my first time back in years, y'all. It gotta be right. It gotta be A1.
I will be releasing a new single in September. So the reclaiming was real for me. I've spent 2 years singing background and touring with Miss Gladys Knight, and it's been great. But although that was a blessing from God and I asked for it, I got lost and I stopped doing the things that I was supposed to do and learning the lessons I was supposed to learn while I was there. I just got comfortable. So you know how when God starts saying, okay, you're not listening, he starts making it uncomfortable.
Nah, come on now.
He starts shaking things up so that you can actually listen. And then when I tuned in, I just knew it was time to reclaim.
Amen. Amen.
So this is the single. You're the first people that gets to hear it.
So no room for error, no room for mistake.
To the earth, black at last and black at first, black unrehearsed, black uninvested, black uninvited, black ill requested, black interested, black entertained, black in something special, baby, black just the same, black like your mamas and black like your daddies, black like you want me and black like you could never have me, black and inconvenient. Black with the burden of proof. Black until proven innocent. Black with the built-in truth. Black and blue. Black and substance abuse. Black with the life that matters. Black with hands up, don't shoot. Black with lead in my water. Black in a subpar school. Black and pipeline to prison. Black single mothers with children. Black and caught up in the system. Black and tired of the division of being black and broke. Black and poor. Black and bleeding. Black before black was needing social media. Black as bland.
Da, 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 da. So much fame.
Don't know how to trust. Don't know how to love.
They say I changed.
Never giving up.
I was broke, but now I'm trying to heal. Promise I'ma keep it real. Telling you exactly how I feel. Seen a lot of lows and I seen a lot of.
So I invited AR over tonight because I don't know. I mean, I have a special place for him in my heart. I feel like every time we get together, it's always I see something different in him. I'm always trying to give some type of inspiration and a positive message to uplift him because I just feel like he needs it. And tonight I wanted to connect with him a little bit better and, you know, just shoot the breeze.
So if you couldn't play no pool, you could have just said that.
Whatever. You couldn't play even. That's why we knocked all my balls inside the hole.
You weren't supposed to tell nobody that.
Because why was we playing pool for 20 minutes and we can't get no damn balls in?
That's crazy. Oh yeah, I ain't gonna lie.
See me on the iPhone though, I'll whoop that ass.
Absolutely.
Send it right now.
Matter of fact, not right now, because we got some stuff we need to talk about. But tonight when you get home, send it. Because I'll be up playing iGames all night.
I bet. And then that's going to decide if you can win on the phone. Then that's who would have won.
Okay, just put it to the test then.
I bet. Say less, man.
So, I pulled up on my boy Jeff, and we just going to hang out. He's really been a very instrumental person for me this year and, like, getting in touch with my emotions and stuff. So, you know what I'm saying? We're going to have a little one-on-one, little kiki, and chat it up.
So, listen, I really just brought you over here because I really just wanted to chat with you. You know, we've been talking about some stuff the last time, last couple times we've been together. And also, I had some concerns. Because I know that the last couple of times we connected has been a little emotional for you.
Yeah.
And
you be pulling that out, but I don't know what it'd be. It'd be like a unspoken, like, don't even, it'd be the feeling, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I am going through it right now so fucking heavy. Life is hitting me, and it's teaching me a very, very important lesson. And so this meeting that I'm having with Jeff, I hope he don't get me emotional, because every time that I do have conversations with him, we can even be in the middle of a fucking party, this man will have me crying. So today I just need a really just a break, a breather, because y'all, it's bad right now.
But I'm trying to get it for my family right now, and I'm hustling my ass off. So that's why I've been distant, because I gotta be, you know what I'm saying? To do what I know, I gotta get into me type shit, you know what I'm saying?
Well, you have to get into you before you get into anybody else.
Yeah, facts.
Before you can be good for anybody else, you have to be good for you.
That's true.
And I know the saying, more money, more problems, no. More money, more people with their money problems. Looking for you to solve them, but I thank God for the dough.
I don't know what it is about him. He just exudes that type of energy that is easy to talk to. And his personality and my personality, we just mesh. And I kind of recognize that from day one. And I feel like he respects me. And he really leans to me for that strength that he needs. So I want to be that person for him. And you don't even know it. Got a little Cairo hair on you.
Oh my gosh. You do this every fucking time, every single time. Like, literally what you was, like, literally when you started speaking. You know, it just resonated before I had came over. I was in the shower. And I had a moment. Mm-hmm. God was speaking to me. Mm-hmm. I broke down. And literally everything you was saying was what he was telling me when I was in the shower. Like, you gotta came too far. Don't get the fuck up.
Yeah.
And it's riding on you. You know what you came to do, so do that. But don't put your head down now. Keep pushing. Keep going.
It's so crazy when someone is speaking to you and you know the message is from a higher power, because it's something that touches your heart, because these are thoughts and these are feelings that you've been having. And they're literally answering these questions. Literally.
Who can't rap?
I can't rap.
Ask him where the music at, or ask him what happened to the track, but then saying he can't rap. Make it make sense. Cause you ain't never wanna do the shit anyway. But it's okay.
gon' show him what you do. Break it back on that man, do your dance like a fool. Humble, steal the show, well, y'all ain't know. Well, probably did, that's the reason I ain't on your show. My flow's colder than New York snow. And if you don't know, now you know. I'm the best, make the B fucking capital. I suck you up, I mean your blood, call me Dracula. My hood in the trunk, catch what I'm saying, bruh. And you don't really want no problems, stop playing, son. I see a couple of baddies, I'm trying to have some fun. Hang in the strip club, a nigga throwing plenty ones. Shake it, make it clap, I'm trying to feel them buns. Left cheek, right cheek, beating like a drum. Run to the nearest exit, come. Follow G, don't forget to bring your pom-poms. Tell the DJ, running back, that's my favorite song. Late nights, early morning, we gon' get it on.
Hold up. You like that shit, son?
When the fuck did you write that verse?
In the studio, working on and wrapping up my project that I'm getting ready to soon release. And, you know, I have a boy band that'll come through so he can get on this track that I actually have for him to get on. You know, and it's about to be a vibe. It's about to get messy.
What up though? Hola. You get on my fucking nerves. What's good, fam?
What's been going on with you, man? How you been?
You know, chilling, filming, recording.
Recording.
Staying busy.
I've been hearing a lot about you. What's going on with the group? How you feeling with the group and shit?
The group is the group.
Yeah. Who you getting along with?
I get along with everybody. You know, so I mean, I don't know, you know, it's just weird energy.
But I'll just honestly keep it real, like, you know, ever since that nigga pulled that shit in the group chat shit like that. You know, it made me take a step back and look back and, you know, have to go back to my street days, the way I was raised and shit like that. Ain't none of these motherfuckers my friends, so I can give a fuck how the fuck you feel, what the fuck you think, and that's how I'm gonna fucking move and operate, cause ain't none of us friends, at least on my end.
Oh, you don't fuck with Ayo?
I'm not gonna say I don't fuck with him, cause I fuck with everybody. Just the incident at hand that happened. It was just like, yeah, bro, I don't know where this came from, and you got my number, so if you want to talk. Don't have an audience and put it in the group chat and come out left field, and I'm like, huh, what? So, you know, holla at me when you see me. Whatever it is, I really, like, bro, so much shit has been going on in my life that I have no time for foolishness or dumbness. So, you know, so
I hope you take that advice, because ain't none of these niggas your friend, bro.
Bro. I got it. I read that shit loud and clear.
Yeah.
Loud and clear. So, shit. Which lands me here. Doing, you know, rapping about my shit, talking about my shit.
Which I heard some of your shit. It sounds good.
Appreciate it. You know, when I recorded this shit and the other day, and I was like, damn, this nigga Bando, you know, he'd sound good on this shit. So, that's why I hit you up and sent it to you. Appreciate you coming out.
Well, you already know I'm already with the shit. So I'm ready for the shit. You know what I'm saying? So can go ahead and knock this out tonight.
Likewise.
Get it
likewise,
over with. You
likewise.
Know? You know? I'm ready when you is.
All in all, it's a great night. You know, we about to finish up what we doing tonight, working on these songs, and can't wait for y'all to hear it, so stay tuned.
So I hustle for it. And if you want your spot back, you better hustle for it, bitch. I put that on the set. Got your bitch on my dick, about to make a mess. Like,
I be with the M-E-S-S.
Alright, so that was cool. What else you got?
I be with the M-E-S-S. I be with the M-E-S-S. Yeah, we with the M-E-S-S. Yeah, we with the M-E-S-S. Yes.
I'm on your ass, foot on the gas. Horny niggas neck, can't let it ride, slide a pass. Crash dummies, ain't getting to the money. Pockets on petite, you piggy banks look hungry. Thrift store clothes always looking bummy. Funny, found a claim restrained you from touching me. Live rent free in your brain, you still love me. Don't wanna test a kid, best believe it gets ugly.
fugly. I'm on my time, don't rush me. With the shits every day, including Sunday. Miseducated, Lauren here rolling Monday. Cause nothing even matters, maybe one day. I be with the M-E-S-S. Yeah, take your time, G. Yeah. When I spit it, I kill it, I get it, I'm hotter than a skillet. Name a nigga better than G, go ahead, wait, I'm listening. Yeah, I did it on him, and I'm shitting on him. Canary yellow diamonds, boy, stay pissing on him. I'm the realest, the illest, no fake shit, so authentic. A lot of niggas waited till I dropped and go and listen. This they on whack, but hear my rhymes and all that shit they spitting. The original, you carbon copies, who you kidding? When I do it, I does it, it's nothing, sky's the limit. If you looking for me, I'm on top, that's where I'm chilling. Getting money, blowing trees, talking music business. Ace of spades, gold bottles, yeah, that's what we sipping. Gold oriented, BMWs is what be driven. House in the hill, man, in colors, how we living. Travel anywhere in the world, yeah, my niggas on the yacht with the Glocks. Yeah, we counting bank figures like a bottle of fine wine. I get better with time, shine bright like a diamond, make the world go blind. I'm so advanced, always feel like I'm ahead of my time. If I ruled the world and everything and it was mine, I'd be.
See me and my niggas, we slide for real. What you gonna do with that chopper? Where I'm from, niggas really roll up and you can get smoked like grabber. Don't give a fuck about your mama on my soul, cause even she can be on receiving end of this pole. We hitting the back streets, catching your niggas like taxis. I'm so done with patsies.
Bro, he need to, bro. That's why I said I ain't got the little shit where I be like, don't spread the lies saying I can't rap, but you knowing I'm 4 to 5. This nigga don't even want to be himself. It's so much turmoil inside. Ask yourself, DeJuan, do you want to be DeJuan or die? Or Power Rangers face. It's morphin' time. Shoot everybody at the wake. Anybody mourn and rise. These bullets are looking for a new home like the mortgage. Ha, I looked at the size of your clothes, bro. And I was mortified. It's a lot of arguing. It's a lot of yelling. It's a lot of you fake. It's a lot of, you know, and I just want the bitches just to, you know what I'm saying? Everybody just get along. Like, stop. You know what I'm saying? Like, don't argue because a bitch like me's here. Don't argue for me. Bitch, do you. Y'all was cool before? Be cool. Don't. Because I don't give a fuck. I'm not going home with none of you hoes. I have one home.
Bitch! So look, this is what we not finna do. You and Teji and y'all little drama, bitch, we finna fix it.
Yeah.
I gotta be so many beef.
Cause it's my thing, right? Like, we all gonna be here. Ain't nobody, we're not finna, like, this the group. Okay. You know what I'm saying? Like, this
I
what
mean,
it is.
If we gotta put another bed in the pool, then we will.
It, I mean, that's cool. That's cool. But we gonna do it all in one night. So Monday, y'all know I got my battle this weekend. I'm going to Chicago. I'm finna go beat his ass.
You been beating me. I've been going viral.
You know what I do.
Choking niggas up.
Look. Straight up. No. So look, after the night, after this weekend, I'm gonna go smoke him. Monday night is the Christmas party. Mm-hmm. You gonna talk to him, bro.
Before
you gonna squash all that shit. No. Monday.
You want him to talk to him on the Christmas
party? Monday. When we get there, there's no point in doing it. Let me tell you something, bro. You disrespect me in public, bro, I address you in public. If I feel like you try me in public, bro, we're going to, you know, that's where it happens at. You know what I'm saying, bro? So what we're going to do is Monday, y'all going to have y'all little 1-2. Y'all going to talk about it. Even if y'all got to shoot the face, I don't give a fuck what y'all do. Y'all going to squash it by the end of Monday. So then moving on to the new year, we don't have none of that extra bullshit. We can move on to the new year. Everybody get into a bag. Like, we not own no silly shit, no weird shit, bro. Moving on to the new year, bro. Everybody together is moving as a unit.
So we hops back upstairs. Guess who the fuck pops up? Your boy J2. And he wants to have conversations about the same bullshit, the same weirdo ass nigga in the motherfucking squad.
My thing is, bro, what is your actual issue with Teji, bro?
He has an issue with me. He don't like me because he want to fuck me. And he
never will. That's what the issue is. And he's jealous of me. And I can read that through our interactions.
Wait, bro. You're not
gonna skip past that. Don't be delusional. What we need to elaborate on?
Bro, you're not gonna skip past that. So when you say he wanna fuck you, bro, has he tried you like that, bro, and you turn him down or some shit like, bro, what? Cause bro, you're not gonna just say no shit like that and just, you know what I mean?
So did they do it? Cause at this point, I'm just kind of thinking that they probably did. Cause why would y'all? That's not cute. I don't think I want to see that. I want to get that vision out of my head. Ayo's cute, but I don't want to see Tay G naked, and I don't want Ayo and Tay G naked at the same time. I'm okay on that.
I mean.
We'll have a conversation with everybody since there's the Christmas party coming up, man.
Christmas party on.
Then we can just address everything. Damn, like I said, my thing is that you acting fun. I'm cool with everybody. I'm cool with everybody. I ain't just got no reason to just be all of it. You're weird acting.
I feel like no time is better than now to really address it because I feel like this beat came out of nowhere and I don't know what's going on. And, I mean, only them two really know what's good. So. But I feel like now is a good time to talk about it because it's getting out of control.
A joke. It's a game. Right. It's not serious. Nothing that you're doing is serious to me.
He's so. Okay.
And you sitting there being salty. Don't do that, bro.
I'm telling you straight up, bro. I'm finna see this nigga tomorrow, bro. And I'm finna tell this nigga tomorrow when I see him, bro. I'm like, hey, look. Ayo feel like A, B, C, and D. Mm-hmm. Bro, I need to know how you feel because Monday, when y'all actually see each other, this is when, you know what I'm saying, y'all gonna be able to express however y'all feel about that shit.
Yeah.
And we need to squash it on Monday, bro, so that we can, bro, Monday's like, bro, it's the end of the year, bro. Nobody's finna go into the new year with you niggas having this little weird beef between each other that don't even mean nothing.
Yeah. No, that's facts.
You know what I'm saying? We can goddamn go into the new year, everything's great, everything great.
So true.
You know what I'm saying, bro? We'll see. I'm gonna hit you tomorrow. As soon as I get done talking with them, with him.
I'm with them.
Them, him, and the other three motherfuckers in his head. I'ma get done talking with him. And we'll chop it up.
I just wanna know if you wanna ask him if he wanna.
I don't have
I'm gonna ask him because bro, that's what he said. He said you wanna fuck me, that's why you be a weird bitch.
I feel like J2 should have stayed out of it. I feel like it has to do with Tay-G and Ayo, and J2 is brand new to the group. You know, I love J2, much respect to him. I love his craft, love what he does, but I don't feel like he know the group well enough to be able to be that mean.
Me personally, I think that I bring people together. I'm more like a jail because I've been in jail. But this is not what we've seen.
So J2 let me know that he gonna link up with Tay-G to go get his side of the story. Which is great because everybody should get their own perspective from that individual. And I can't wait until he sees with his own eyes that Tay-G is a fake ass bitch.